Howdy, folks, and welcome once more.
Let's play Witcher 3.
Today, palling around with Roach. Thankfully, we have a fast travel right down there, so I don't have to worry about actually going there on my own. Mostly because it's a pain in the ass. I will warn you guys, this is probably going to be a slightly shorter episode, maybe about 20 minutes or so. Cutscenes willing. Work was busy tonight. Normally, I record this on Sunday after work, and we're home by, like, you know, 1 o'clock. It's 4:50. I just got home, so... yeah. Not my usual span. What's up, Roach?
Ready?
My contact awaits at the chess club. Let's get this over with.
Come on.
All right. I'm gonna laugh if it's like some half giant or something.
Something's not right.
Let's see what. Checkmate. They say it's the game of kings. That chess teaches one to think strategically. What a load of rubbish. Both sides have identical pieces. The rules stay invariably the same. How does this mirror real life? Witcher, do you know why I play chess? To kill time? I have no time to squander, let alone kill. I play chess to reveal the game's secret. Blood thumps inside these chessmen. You need only listen, and you will hear. Dub-dub. 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 A heart pumping with life. I take a pawn, and I hear flesh being rent. I win a piece, and I hear screams from the depths of its bowels. I want to break the chessmen open. Squeeze the truth from them. Do you see what I mean?
No, I don't.
You do not, because you are not a king. Pawns see only their comrades at their sides and their foes across the field. A king has a different view of the chessboard. His greatest foes surround him. His own chessmen might trap him. And that is check and death. You see, Witcher, chess is the art of sacrificing your own pieces. Now do you see?
I think I do now.
Unimportant. Let us speak. Why have you brought the Witcher here?
I think he'd best explain.
I'm looking for Cyprian Wiley, Horson Jr. I know Redania supports him.
Why do you seek him?
It's personal.
Fair enough. I'll not pry. I have placed Junior in a mansion in Oxenfurt. Very few know this.
They'll not let you in unannounced. Thus, you must tell them you've come about the new whores.
Junior constantly requests fresh women. I hear he doesn't treat them well.
You'd just give me a man after investing coin and time in him? Can't help but wonder why.
Consider it a gesture of goodwill. Almost. I'll expect you to return the favor.
And also, Junior has lost his purpose. The Big Four is no more.
I shall contact you to collect in due course. Now go. And you, Roach. We must speak another time.
Radovid's sinking ever deeper into madness as I see it.
I know where to find Junior. Don't really care beyond that.
Geralt, come to think of it, I too wanted to ask a favor. I have a terrible problem with Vess. Need someone to talk some sense into her. Come see me at the camp. I'll tell you more.
Let me think about it. See you, Roach.
All right.
You look it up.
I mean, we're not going to think about that at all when you're going to go and help Roach and see what's up with Vess. He is my top priority at the moment. Because that's how bros work! Quest failed. Oh no. Okay, it looks like he's around here.
Oi, clumsy ass.
Now, witches. They can't
just
catch
them. Mildly on fire. I'm okay. No, how you doing, Roach?
Geralt of Rivia. Safe and sound.
What do you do here? Hunt Squirtel?
You jest, right?
We've already done this.
Temeria.
Mentioned you have a problem.
It's Vess. She took a couple of lads across the river. She plans to hit the Black Ones at Mulberdale.
So, sounds about like what guerrilla fighters do.
Yes, when they're ordered to. Whereas I forbade her from leaving camp. Indefinitely.
Why Mulberdale? Why'd Vess go there?
The peasants from the village aided us earlier. The Nilfgaardians learned of this. Word got out they're planning a punitive expedition. Probably hang every fifth villager.
Honestly, Vess's desire to save the villagers makes sense. What doesn't is your opposition to the plan.
War means death. Not only for the soldiers, for the common folk as well. You can't save them all, it's that simple.
Funny. Had you for an idealist.
You were right to. Are right to. But I have one ideal. A free Temeria. And I'm prepared to sacrifice anything for it.
Don't trust Vess anymore?
Bollocks. She's prepared to die for me. Ah, no, that's not the problem. Know what distinguishes a soldier from a common swashbuckler?
The uniform.
It's a serious question.
A rhetorical one. So instead of waiting for an answer, just enlighten me.
Soldiers think tactically. They know when to strike, when to fall back, when to charge and when to hold. Vess finds this difficult. She's impulsive, hot-headed. Yet in guerrilla warfare, one false step and you're fucked. I confined her to the camp because I feared that sent out she'd go rabid and make a mistake. I was right.
All right, so you've got a problem. Insubordination. What am I supposed to do about it?
I doubt Vess has entered the village. More likely she and the boys lie in wait in the woods nearby. We must find her before she attacks and stop her. You're a good tracker. Help me.
Count me in.
Thanks, Geralt. I'll owe you a favor. Meet me in Velen beneath the Hanged Man's Tree. It's just a short jaunt from there to Mulberdale.
Man, Roach, I don't... You will, like, never owe me a favor, dude.
You trouble me, Glylox.
That's not how this works, my friend. You crossbow a motherfucker before he cuts my head off, and... Nah, I got your back forever. Simple. Let's see, the hangman's tree. Been a while since we've been out this way. Long while. Go ahead and flag this in our journal. Level 12, we're even over leveled for it. Nice. Feels good, man.
It's the village below. Black with Nilfgaardians already. They're preparing to execute folk.
No sign of Vess.
She may be impetuous, but she's not stupid. She's waiting for her moment. Probably attack after dusk once.
Shh.
What now?
A trio. Lightly equipped, sneaking closer, over there near the...
Death to the Black Ones!
Ethne! Sirka!
Looks like we're too late.
Oh man, we're getting in on this.
Follow me.
What? Dude. Oh, look at this sword! Holy shit. That's pretty badass. Squirtle got a flair for fancy killing implements, I gotta give him that. Vess, you better not be dead. You are not allowed to die. You're too cool for that. Fucking roach, man! Dude just fucking killed that dude. What's up, buddy? God almighty. Oh no, she is taking damage. God damn it, game. Let me do the thing. What's up, Vess? How you doing? I'm back. Fuego. Fuego, I say. Oh. Alright, fine. We'll play like this. You burn.
God damn it, Vess. Have you gone completely mental? You ignore my orders, go off on a suicide mission, and instead of donning a breastplate, you dash into battle, shirt open, navel and whatnot exposed.
You're not my father, Roach. You've no right to tell me what to wear.
But I am your commander, and you will obey me. Guerrilla warfare. Warfare! It involves armies, for fuck's sake.
I could not abandon them. They helped us.
It's a soldier's job to kill, Vess, not save, not rescue. If that is not to your liking, join the Sisters of Melitele. Study to be a healer. Fucking hell. Give me your weapon. You'll get it back when you wise up, if you wise up. Move out!
Ren.
One left.
You took my weapon, Roach. So I must manage with my bare hands.
Leave him alone. There are corpses enough here.
What?
You heard me.
I did, and I can't believe it. He came here to murder civilians. He's seen us. Will you have him return to his camp and report?
Emhyr knows we can kill his men. Let him learn that we can also show mercy.
Roach is right. Besides, killing a defenseless...
What is it with you, Roach? Did the Witcher take your stones? They're sadists. He's the occupier.
I will explain later. You, Nilfgaardian, piss off.
Morentai, nes dirmad ava.
Go, before I change my mind. We should go before a patrol comes along. Thank you, Geralt. Ever need any help, you know where to find me.
Charge into battle, not with a breastplate, but with your navel and your whatnots hanging out. Oh, I love this game so much. I'm gonna loot all the bodies. Thank you. Thank you. Is that a wild hunt sign I just picked up? I think it was. This? No. This. Oh, Temerian Special Forces insignias. Junk. Alright. Frickin' garbage. Damn Temerians, actually. Armor upgrades? Anywhere? No? No? Huh? Fancy boots. Why am I wearing... Ah, mine are the Igni boots. Okay. Do the now. Look at that sword! Oh, my other one. Oh, wow, that was... Oh, this one glows too. Nice. Sweet. We got, like, two fuck huge glowing swords. Ain't nobody gonna give a shit now. Okay. So let's see what we were doing here. Get Junior. Get inside Horson's hideout. Oh my god, Geralt. Jesus. At least they let us fast travel into this town. That's, you know, staying something. Alright. I don't suppose you guys will just let me in. What's up?
What do you want?
Where's Horson Jr.?
Oh, this one's got bollocks, don't he? I know you, you motherfucker. Saw you kill Olgard and Vic.
Believe I did have the pleasure to meet those two gentlemen. What were the names again? Olgard and Vic? Give them my regards.
I love it! I love that this game lets me just fucking kill everybody that pisses me off. Oh, it feels so good. I'm surprised it didn't let us axie those guys, honestly. What's up? This is my sword. It does a lot of damage, like too much damage. But it feels satisfying. Honestly, God almighty, it feels better, like on these trash enemies like this, to just kill them in one or two hits. Because, like, they're fucking garbage, right? Geralt is, like, one of the best swordsmen in the world, to my understanding. Like, it makes sense to me that he would be able to just, like, do what I just did here and wade through a crowd of guys with, like, next to no effort. Till, like, a peasant sneaks up on him and rams a pitchfork through his guts. But we don't talk about that. Alright, Horson. Where you at, buddy? Oh, oh. What's up? Alright. Neat. I'll take it. You guys wanna go as well? I'm in the market for some experience points. God almighty. I don't think that's how swords work. Pretty sure that's not how swords work. I've been told that with regards to Silver Swords, Harpy, the one that we have, is actually one of the better weapons in the game. So that's cool. We'll probably be using these things if I had to guess for the rest of this playthrough, unless I go full Rule of Cool and we find something that just looks nifty. What's up, guys? Way you go. I don't even know why that one lit on fire. I just poked him. Oh, that's right. I think we've got runes that let us introduce people to the world of proper fuego application. Good jump, Geralt. A+. Anything in here? No. Alright. Oh, we'll go upstairs at Geralt's leisurely pay. Oh, wearing. I was like, it won't let me run. Probably because I'm carrying so many corpses worth of random garbage. The inventory system in this game sucks, and I hate it. I'm just gonna be honest. It makes no sense how it... Like, if I mouse over something, like, see how this is glowing? When I hit R, it should drop it, but if I hit R, it's going to drop one of these things, because that's what's selected. It just feels backwards. Alright. Oh no, it's... Ah, oh, there we go. Oh.
Fucking degenerate. He so much as touched Ciri, he'll pay.
Jesus.
Nailed it to the wall.
What the sandwich fuck is this? No! Fuck me! Help me, for fuck's sake!
No one's coming.
Stop! What? What do you want?
Hello, Junior. I've come to talk.
I'll do whatever you want.
Got a few questions to start with.
I'll tell you everything.
I'm looking for a young woman and a minstrel. I know you've met them.
A bird? What fucking...
Ashen-haired with a sword on her back, just like me.
Yeah, yeah. That was... I remember.
Pay attention now. You'll tell the truth. Wanna know why?
I won't lie. Honest.
Took me a long time to find you. Wasn't an easy road to travel. I'm angry and tired. Had to kill a lot of people along the way. Some of them tried to cheat me. Some tried to lie. I didn't like it one bit. I feel like one more lie'd be the last bitter drop in a chalice full of sorrow. And then I'd do something I would later regret. Now you know why you can't lie to me?
Yes.
Good. I'd like to know how the ashen-haired woman ended up meeting you, and what happened to her.
What happened to her? She attacked me!
Lie one more time, and I'll cut your balls off.
We'd made a deal. I was to repair their magic filler, what's it? That girl and the songster were to bring me Siggy Ruvin's treasure. They didn't, so I might have flown off the handle a bit, I admit.
What did you do?
I nabbed their flunky, Dodo, and waited for them to come for him. Look, this. Here's what they wanted fixed.
A phylactery? You can fix something like this?
Not me. I know a guy.
Wasting my time, Junior. I need details.
I'll tell you. Tell you all. Just the way it happened.
Got a bad feeling about this.
Calm down, Dandelion. You can't leave Dudu in Horson Jr.'s hands, you know that.
I know, but my gut can't be reasoned with, and no amount of sympathy I feel can silence it, blot it out.
Get a grip, Dandelion. We must focus on the task at hand.
I'm just saying.
Well then be silent. Have you learned where Horson is keeping Dudu?
Room on the top floor. One with the balcony.
I'll need to cross onto the roof. Wait for me in front of Junior's house. And... I know it's difficult, but do try to look inconspicuous.
If they hurt you, Horson will pay.